To Melbourne with love, I fly to you. Once wiser since my goodbye to you, I've traveled the world to love. I fly to you. With love,
welcome back to the Shtick, and we're still with Ilan Kidron.
That's
who
right,
I've never
man.
Heard of before this. Now, actually, I knew of you from the Sheer Madness Festival. I heard about you, and I was there every year filming it, and you were always there and the da-da-da, but I had no idea that you had such an enormous backstory.
Lovely to hear that. So you might even know my mum, Jeanette Kidron, because she was very busy with Gary Holtzman and the whole crew with Sheer Madness. Anyway, yes, so good to actually formally meet you now, Henry. I love your work as well. Love everything about the shtick.
Thank you.
And, you know, I really hope that we can build on it, you know, and do something together.
That's what I said to Sarita in the first segment. I said, this is going to be, and that's the reason why to call you immediately, because when I did the Danira Boys a few weeks ago, I Googled Danira and found Danira.org and then the Danira Project. And this is, you are the head creative of arts and culture with
them. Well, something like that. You know, it's still very young. I mean, we launched the whole platform 3.5 months ago. You know, when we went into lockdown, and it was an emergency response to an emergency situation where we figured out that older adults would be stuck in their kind of isolation for a lot longer than most of us. And these were the people who were going out and seeing great culture, who were going to Camelot, which is a great venue up here, going to the Opera House, going to places like that, Melbourne, Sydney, all locked down. So what are we going to do? But we decided to create this creative culture hub. And it's kind of exploded, you know, in more than we could have imagined in such a short time, which just goes to show how hungry people are. And not just older adults, but it's you know, spreading to anyone. So our whole platform is all about content that interests Jews, not just Jewish content, but content that might interest Jews. The way I like to express what we have on Danira, the metaphor, is that, you know, I do quite a few, you know, I used to be a touring rock star, and now I'm more of a black belt in bar mitzvahs just because of, you know, family man. But if you go to a bar mitzvah and just play Jewish music, people aren't going to be interested for too long. You've got to put in Elton John. You've got to put in, you know, new top 40 stuff. You've got to put in, you know, Stevie Wonder and all the great loved pop songs of all time. So that is the content that Jews are interested in. So we mix it up. Any day you can go on Danira and it's a plethora of different kind of stuff. So we realized pretty quickly that people want to feel a sense of belonging to a strong community through wellness programs, culture, even sports, whatever it is that interests. And we're open for business. We want people to come in and contribute. People like you, Henry, you know.
Exactly. Well, when I saw your website and looked at some of the content, I was so impressed. I really was. I thought, my first thought was, this is what I've always wanted the shtick to be, because we have the same fundamental idea, right, of having a Jewish program with Jewish content, but also to go out to the wider community, which is our platform on Channel 31 allows us to do that, and going to YouTube as well. But somehow or other, between you and Sarita and, you know, the other chap who was involved who's your CEO?
Danny Grimberg's our CEO. So he's also actually, he's a great aggregator of content from all around the world, because he is hungry. He just watches everything. And, you know, actually probably half the programming on there is from Danny just surfing around at 10 a.m. And, but, you know, I take huge interest and love in having around me 10 to 12 people that recommend stuff to me that I can then funnel in, things like what the New York Philharmonic might be putting on, or, you know, little theatres in Czechoslovakia might be putting something on that could interest. So, you know, I'm lucky I've got a lot of great people. You know, we don't care if you're religious or not. I don't care if you're kosher or vegetarian or carnivore or gay or straight or whatever. You know, like, if I just
with us.
I want stimulating content, compelling content, that brings us together. You know, it's all an education. It's all supposed to be, you know, about creativity and wellness, and just, it's got to be full of nutrition, you know. I don't care.
And we found during isolation that it's the most important thing is connectedness, that human beings really need to connect. And with lockdown, we've seen that, you know, using the facilities, the technology we have, has opened up a whole new stream of, through education, through business, and through the media. It's overkill in some ways, because I've got like 6 Zooms in one night.
Well, I mean, that's what I found. So, for example, we're trying to be quite innovative with some of our programming. Now, not only do we aggregate stuff from around the world, we also create our own content. One of our shows that I run is called Synchronicity. And what I noticed, what happened so quickly on the net is lots of musos putting on their songs, split screens with lots of other musicians and singing songs. And I thought they were fantastic. But what I felt it was really missing was dance and movement and something to watch. So I got in touch with my friend Linda Gamblin, who's the head of training at Sydney Dance Company, and just said, look, I want to mesh music, traditional music, with unconventional partnerships with contemporary dance, and see what happens if you smash it together. And what's resulted in this is this fantastic series where musicians are all of a sudden working with dancers that they wouldn't otherwise have done, and filmmakers. And I've really enjoyed that show. I recommend it to you to watch it.
No, I've seen it, mate. I've checked it out. And on Saturday night when you did To Melbourne With Love, I loved the dance sequences. They were a real highlight, and the poetry with the sea rolling in. And the array of different artists. You had Idan Rachel and David Broza coming in from Israel. You had Ben Lee coming from LA. You had Dan Rosen doing one of his songs, which I, you know, we love Dan. He's like a total.
Have you had him on the show?
Huh?
Have you had him on the show?
No, but he's one of my oldest friends.
You should get Dan on the show. I mean, he'd love to have a shtick with you.
I did have him performing on the Sheer Madness show.
Great.
He was the MC at the second last show.
That's right. That's right. Fantastic. We also, you know, I did get a lot of friends, but I was also introduced to people I didn't know as well. So we had Baby and Lulu, for example. We had Jessica Mowboy on board. But then there were, you know, there were others that, you know, were recommendations that you know, just meant a lot. And it also felt nice doing that in memoriam to Ruth Bader Ginsburg, that Nick
Herter,
you know, that Nikki delivered. That, you know, it was just a warm, fun time, and I'm so happy that it's something that it was sort of our coming out party, but it was also something really. The main thing was just to bring some joy to a lot of people. Some of the messages that I got sent, just can't believe it. You know, a woman who'd lost her husband to COVID during it, and who that was right at the beginning, and she'd just gone through hell, and she was just saying how much light this had brought to her, and that's why we do it. You know, that's why we do
it. Yeah. Well, there were a lot of highlights, but something I did want to mention, though, was the Yom Kippur events that you did at the Emmanuel Synagogue with Orna Trigoboff and Elisa and Oscar. That blew my mind. I saw you on Friday, what night was it? Sunday night for Kol Nidre. And that was sensational. And the thing that really blew me away on the Saturday night was Issa Faglin. We have to just give him a mention.
Yeah, he's a wonderful, wonderful guy. He's got a lot of family down in Melbourne. And he is the cantor at Mizrahi up here, which is an Orthodox synagogue. Actually, he got up and I thought it was very brave of him and very beautiful for him to sing with Eliza. He sang Halev Sheli, which is a beautiful song, which tells the tale of Miriam, and it's a very important song. And then, so yeah, for him to get up and play with Brooklyn Bear, they're called Oscar and Eliza, have a little duet called Brooklyn Bear. I thought it was wonderful. And then to join them the next night in a service that I'd never done before. I'd done on its own, you know, once or twice in my life, but to need to lead that whole experience was definitely something I'll treasure. I hope to do it for years to come. Another couple that's definitely worth mentioning that was on the show, Henry, is Yelena Katz-Chernin, the great composer. You know, we've been working with soprano Eleanor Lyons, who wasn't there live, but we screened for the Ruth Bader Ginsburg tribute. She was vocalise for Fred, which is one of her famous pieces. Very moving, very beautiful.
Yeah, I got shivers down my spine. You know, it was so brilliant.
That's the idea.
Well, I'm getting them now.
I get the impression, Henry, that you might just cry on cue, really. You seem like a very emotional man who can, you know, who can feel those shivers and cry when you don't meet, you know, at the drop of a hat. I'm like that, yeah.
Yeah, well, I get camel tears, not crocodile tears, camel tears, and they're very dry. So it's been really great to have you on, Ilan.
Great pleasure. Thank you so much.
Really, I was going to get you on for three segments, but then I discovered Sarita. I thought, let's combine you two guys, because we could easily do another segment now. But we'll be doing an extended version for YouTube.
Great.
And we'll be in touch. We want to do some synchronicity and synergy, please.
I love it. Please come on board, De Niro, as well. We can partner on, you know, whatever you're interested in. You know, we can use a lot of common sort of belief and nachas that we can, you know, head towards together.
And who was the lady that did Bette Midler? She was brilliant. What was her name?
Kat Alcorn. And she doesn't have a Jewish bone in her body.
But no.
She puts that on so well. We had her on a cooking show on De Niro called Babka with Bette. And she came on, she cooked a thing in her life as well. It was absolute chaos. You can see, you can catch up with it on De Niro. We've got a catch-up section where you can
go.
But yeah, coming up as well, we've got Cabaret and Creme Brulee coming up, which is
that's
a cooking
show. Bit of jazz?
It's a bit of Baby and Lulu. It'll be a French music show.
Oh, right.
And, you know, we've got always stuff on there. We've got a new show called Song Butlers, which is basically I've got a few brilliant artists, you know, every week being human jukeboxes that people can send their requests in beforehand. We tailor a show towards everyone. We're also, you know, one of our main things is for us to be able to you know, pay musicians as well. So being able to be put in and stimulate the culture economy, you know, that's what we're all about as well. So we're looking forward to a great future there and being able to be a platform that lots of people can come in and out of. And, you know,
Sydney is a wellspring of a goldmine of amazing talent, really. And
we're online, so we're looking for Melbourne people to join us. You know, we're looking for contributors in any way. If anyone has good ideas for shows and they want to use us as a playground, that's what we're here for. We're here to support you guys. I'll happily help produce shows if anyone out there is interested. It doesn't matter what age. If you guys want to start a book club or a poetry club or whatever it is, please, that's what we're looking for. We want we're looking for you. We'd love to join forces with anyone out there.
All right, Ilan, we love your shtick.
Love yours.
And we'll see you very soon on the Danira platform. The website's going up now, and we're going out with a bit of music just to do the title. There's only two guests this week, you and really thank you so much.
Thanks,
I wish you well into the new year.
Yep. See you later. Bye-bye.
Shalom. Shalom, Havel. Shalom. Au revoir, mon ami.
Au revoir, mon ami. A bientôt.
Ciao, ciao.
Because the map to all our hearts is written in the sand, and the universe can wash away all your best laid plans. If we're four around a table or 40,000 strong, I will find a sweet surrender in knowing when I'm wrong. I want to do it right. How can we live forever in a single night? Suspended in the glitter of Orion, never fading. Two stars together blazing in a perfect light. I want to do it right. I want to do it right. I want to do it right. I think it just finishes there. Let's begin again.